Hi everyone! Thank you for checking out my channel. Thank you for clicking on this video. This video is part of the series of videos I'm posting to try to help people out when it comes to aptitude tests, like the civil service exam. This video in particular is part of my series on math. Today we're going to talk about thresholds. Now, thresholds is actually part of yung workbook natin. So if you don't have a copy of the workbook yet and you want to get a copy of this and the other review materials, go and send me a message www.facebook.com/teamlaiga so you'd know kung paano kayo makakuha ng ganito. Okay? Now, if you have a copy of the workbook, you can follow along. Thresholds is on page 2. So, page 2, that is what we're going to discuss right now. And then, I'm going to show you better by switching over to my PC. So, see you in a bit. We're going to talk about thresholds. No? Yung thresholds, again, nasa workbook yan. If you have a workbook of your own, follow along. Yung thresholds is actually just a speed math technique. I put it in the first pages of the workbook. The reason for that is para matrain natin yung brain to work a certain way. And this is how I do my mental math computations. This is also how I do yung estimation natin. Kasi there are times, for example, na makakakuha tayo ng mga questions like, for example, 75,852. Yung mga ganyan, medyo mahabang mga numbers multiplied by another big number, like sabihin natin 2260, something like that. And then, we are going to estimate kung ano yung tamang sagot. Now, just by looking at this, syempre, medyo complicated kasi ang dami nating i-multiply. If you multiply the traditional way, ganyan yan, tapos layers, 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 and layers. But if kahit papano makakatulong na mag-estimate, because sabihin na natin na yung options ay iba-iba ng number of digits, then that could be a way for you to speed up yung pagsasagot ninyo, yung process na pagsasagot. Kasi you can look at this as 75,000 times 250. Okay? Now, I know if this is smaller than this, and this is smaller than this, but ang importante dun is, if alam ninyo medyo, alam ninyo yung range na sagot nito, okay, you can know na yung tamang answer has to be higher than this. Anything lower would be incorrect. So that is how nakakatulong yung technique ng thresholds. And in order for me to explain better kung ano yung kinakailangan for you to understand, I'm going to show you this table. This table is in the workbook if you have one. And the reason why I put that there is for you to practice yung thinking in thresholds. Kaya thresholds, kasi ang thresholds is yung levels. You have 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 50, 75. These are numbers na actually kaya ninyo i-mental math if you alam niyo yung process. For example, you take 15. Ito yung lowest. 15 times 2, madali pa i-mental yan, that is 30. Dalawang 15 is 30. Okay? But we usually stop there. And if you multiply all of these numbers by 2, medyo kakayanin naman. You have 40, 50, 60, 70, 100, and 150. Right? Kaya natin lahat ng times 2. But the problem is, most of us stop sa times 2. When actually, madali na to get all of these things and even yung bigger numbers just as long as alam ninyo yung times 2. Let me show you. Ang times 2 kasi ay dalawang times 4. Okay? Ano ibig sabihin nun? Kung ang 10 times 2 ay 20, ang 10 times 4 is 20 times 2 or 40. Right? So, ibig sabihin nun, ang 15 times 4 is dalawang 30 or 60. Okay? What does that mean for everything else? Ganun din. So, ang times 4 ng 20 is pwedeng times 2 na lang nito, which is 80. This is going to be 100. This is going to be 120. This is going to be 140, 200, and 300. Okay? So again, just knowing yung threshold number, yung times 2 number can help a lot. Another example of thinking in the way of thresholds is times 5. If you look at times 5, that is basically times 4 plus times 1. Okay? Ibig sabihin nun, looking at this, kung 15 times 5, pwede nyo na lang gawing 60 plus 15, that is 75. Okay? So, ano ibig sabihin nun? You can do it for all the numbers out there in the real world. Let me give you an example. For example, you have the number 240. Okay? I-multiply daw natin siya sa 5. Okay, aside from the times 5 method that I teach, you can also go about doing this by knowing na ang times 2 ng 240 in your mind is 480. Dalawa nun times 2 uli, that is going to be another 480. Okay? Pag pinagsama mo yan, that is going to give you 960 plus isa pang 240. This is going to give you the correct answer, which is 1,200. Okay? So again, ito ay recommendation ko for you to kind of speed up yung math mental process ninyo. So ang times 8 ng 15, mag-jump lang tayo sa ibang numbers, times 8 ng 15, kung dati hindi natin kayang i-mental math, you could think of it na ang times 8 ay 4 na times 2. So 4 times 30 is 120. Okay? In the same way na yung, kung titignan natin yung 35 times 8, okay, parang ang hirap i-mental math, right? But if you look at it na ang times 2 ay 70, okay, times 4 na lang nun para makuha mo yung times 8. 7 times 4, madali na yun. 7, 14, 21, 28, 280. So that is how it helps yung mental math. Times 10, madali naman kasi dadagdagan mo na ng 0. So this is 150, 200, 250, 300, 350, 500, and 750. Dadagdagan mo na lang ng times 2. At dahil ito yung mga times 2, this is going to be 180, 150 plus 30. This is going to be 240, 200 plus 40, and so on and so forth. So, itong mas creative way of multiplying is something that you can practice. Okay? And that is my suggestion to you guys. Kasi, for example, if you have a number like 350 times 19, di ba? Medyo complicated kung inlong cut natin yan kasi dalawang layers yan. Pero if you think of it na 350 na lang times 20, which is just times 2 plus dalawang 0, this is going to be 70 at dalawa pang 0, so 7,000. This is times 20 minus isang 350 para maging 19 kasi 20 minus 1 is 19. This is something that you can do mentally. This is going to give you 6,650. Again, mental kasi sanay kayo sa thresholds. So that is the explanation for that page. Now, if you don't get it right away, that's okay. Kasi this is something that needs practice. But I'm offering up this suggestion kasi pagdating sa exam, you only have a few seconds to answer the question. So kung kaya ninyo mag-estimate, that can be a good way for you to know the answer without actually solving anything. Now, may solve this with me dun sa workbook. If you have your workbook, you can follow along. This is the question. Sabi, Sandy went to the bank to deposit coins. She had a huge bag of 25-cent coins. If she told the teller that the bag had 2,500 in it, how many coins should be there? Ano ibig sabihin nun? Meron daw siyang, okay, malaking bag ng barya. Okay? So, meron siyang barya. Natig to 25 cents. At kailangan daw, pumunta siya sa bank. Ang laman daw is 2,500. Ngayon, chinek nung teller kung magkano ang laman, ilang piraso daw dapat ang 25 cents ang laman. Now, the problem with this is, pag tinignan nyo yan, okay, ang sabi ng teacher, titinan mo daw yung mga given, right? So, you have 25 cents, which is 0.25, and you have 2,500, which is yung pesos. The problem is, most people stop here. Hindi na nila alam kung anong gagawin next. Bakit? Hindi mo alam. I-multiply mo ba yan? I-divide mo ba yan? Siguro hindi naman addition, no? Kasi masyadong maliit. Hindi rin naman subtraction kasi magiging masyadong madali yon. So, manamang either multiplication or division. Now, this is something that I always ask sa mga live review events. I ask them, anong tingin niyo ang gagawin? Multiplication or division? And in the live review events, in which I teach this this technique and a lot more, actually, most of the ones na hindi ko kayang gawin ng video, I teach in the live review events, I ask them. Kasi sa live review events, merong rule na walang mga okray sa isa't isa. So you can raise your hand, you can answer the wrong answer, that's okay, walang judgment. And so I ask them na mamili, mumultiply ba o i-divide? And usually, sa room, 50-50 yan, may 60-40. Ibig sabihin nun, siguro 60%, think multiplication, 40% of the room, think the division. Or minsan, baliktad. Okay? Pero basically, hati ang opinion ng mga tao kung i-multiply ba yan o i-divide. And that is the problem pagdating sa actual exam. Kasi tumatagal yung pagsasagot kasi hindi alam ko anong operation ang gagamitin. Right? And you may be nodding your head kasi ganun ka rin when you encounter questions like this. So, if you answered multiplication, 0.25 times 2,500, that's actually wrong. The correct answer is you should divide it. So 2,500 divided by 0.25. The next problem is this. Hindi alam nung iba or nakalimutan na kung paano mag-divide ng decimal. And it's really very complicated to divide a decimal number. Okay? So anong mangyayari dito? Sometimes you get stuck here. So hindi pa rin makukuha yung sagot. Now, this is my suggestion. Before we solve it using the long cut, here's my suggestion. Praktikalan lang tayo. Usapang thresholds. Ang 25 cents, 0.25, right? Tanong, ilang benching ko mayroon sa isang piso? Okay? Ilang benching ko meron sa piso? Now, lahat naman tayo siguro marunong magbilang ng barya, no? Kasi naninindahan tayo lahat, nagbabayad tayo ng pamasahe, lalo ng mga panahon na 750 ang pamasahe. So, ano ibig sabihin nun? Alam natin na may apat na benching ko sa isang piso. Right? So, ibig sabihin nun, sa tanong na ito, meron kang 2,500 na piso, bawat isang piso na yan, merong apat na benching ko. So, instead of doing this, you can do 2,500, which is yung dami ng piso, times 4 na lang. Mas madali ba yan? Yes, lalo na if you know your thresholds. Kasi ang 25 times 4 is 100. Dagdagan mo lang ng dalawa pang 0, the answer would be 10,000 pieces. So again, if you're familiar with your barya, with your thresholds, marunong kayo mag-Tagalog or mag-Tagalize ng problem, this would be no problem at all to you. And this is actually something that lumabas nung ako nag-exam, ganyang klaseng tanong. So that is what I want to teach you right now. Now, if we check using the traditional method, you can move the decimal place, 1, 2, and then magdadagdag tayo ng dalawang 0. Okay? Kasi kung ano yung minove dito, mamove sa kabila. You have 1, 25, and then you have 0, 0, 0, and another 0. 10,000 pieces. Pareho lang din ang sagot. So, tama rin tayo. Kaya lang, ang tanong na, ano ang mas madali? Okay? So, again, ang thresholds, the technique, the concept is something na I teach in the library events to kind of open your eyes sa different ways of solving the problems. Kasi minsan, masyado tayong fixated dun sa scratch paper, paper and pencil technique na natutunan natin in school. But we forget that there are other alternatives. Okay, so let's try this. Okay, I'm going to ask you to hit pause now and try to figure out this question by yourself. Hit pause. All right, let's see how you did. Okay, kanina, 25 cents. Ngayon, 10 cent coin. So, anong tanong? Ang tanong natin is, ilang 10 cents mayroon sa piso? The answer here would be 10. Diba? 10 piraso ng 10 cents equals sa piso. Ngayon, ang pera is still 2,500. So, ilang pirasong barya ang laman? That will be 2,500 times 10. So, dadagdagan lang natin ang isang 0. 2,500, isa pang 0. The answer is 25,000. It's that easy. In seconds, you can solve it. And I'm going to teach more of these mga speed math techniques natin and other stuff na exclusive in the library event. So, if you are attending, I'm excited for you. See you soon. And God bless sa inyong lahat. Alright, I hope you learned something today. If you did, click thumbs up. Make sure that you share this video with your friends if mag-exam din sila. And if you have a copy of the workbook already, make sure that you answer all the exercises sa ilalim para makatulong sa inyong preparation for the next exam that you're going to take. Thank you guys, and make sure that you're subscribed to this channel kasi there are more videos coming up. If you're watching this on YouTube, hit the bell icon para magkaroon ka ng notification as soon as the new video posts. There are lots more coming, and I hope that you are here to catch that. So thank you guys. God bless. Aja, kaya niyan. See you soon. Bye for now.